One of his things that he posted under his picture, this is what he wrote about himself. What a year. A lot of trials, suffering, tears, and heartache past any level I've ever faced in my life. It is though my heart has been poked and stabbed at until I was forced to spit it out, only for it to be left completely at the hands of its creator to heal and take care of. What better hands for it to be in than love itself? God, you've been wanting direct eye contact with me, and it took me a while to realize it. Even when I did, I felt like I could do things my way. In turn, I got my heart broken and had nowhere else to go. Well, nowhere else that could truly restore me rightfully. To go from feeling like I was chosen to then face what was on the other side, it left me asking, why me? The last thing I want is to look stupid or be called stupid, dumb, or crazy. But you don't care. You only call me by what is good. You only show me love. You are the only validation I need. It took until now for me to get that. So thank you for being so loving and so perfect. Thank you for showing me what love is. Thank you even for the storms that were sent my way. Through it all, you've been by my side, teaching me and growing with me, and I'm still here, right? So it sounds like some pretty sweet victories to me. Many more to come, and no matter what, I know you got me.
Unashamed of your smile. It's okay. It's okay to not like the same music. I grew up different, and not in a way that was ratchet or bougie. Instead, I was obsessed with happy endings, living inside my own head, so my life was like a movie. I didn't like always watching chick flicks because I would be the first one to cry. And I was never a fan of horror movies either. The fact that other people actually enjoyed nightmares and heart attacks, I never understood why. See, what drew my attention was the fantasy and sci-fi. I knew Disney. I knew Lion King. I love Incredibles. I'm a Star Wars type of guy.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Luke.
Avatar The Last Airbender was my favorite TV show ever. No other one could compare. I had every episode on DVD and was this close to shaving off all my hair. If you've never seen it, you're a square. But I'm not going to keep going because you might think I'm crazy when I tell you I haven't seen one episode of Martin or Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. I know. Leave me alone. Hey, I did Buckets, though. I did Buckets, though, and I don't got to think twice. Me and my bro Corey used to go at it day and night. He was Kobe, I was Mike. To this day, I give anybody a prop, you feel me, because ball is life. That's right. Hey, they can square up, they can fight. But at the end of the day, I know I'm nice.
But not as nice as my grandma cooking, though. Ooh.
I mean, grandma just so down in the kitchen, you know what I'm saying? I'm not just saying that because at the end of the day, I know everybody gonna say that grandma can cook. But my grandma, she got like these secret recipes, and I swear they off the hook. I mean, they had you shook. You be running back to her like, look. Can I have some more? Because that was bomb. And she walked up to me like, baby D, you want something to eat? I'd be like, yes, grandma. She'd be like, okay. Grandma made beef stroganoff. Mwah. Come on up and bring a plate. See, mom will cook too. She just didn't always feel like it. But when she did, it was good too. She always told me that I needed something to cook. So I did. First thing I learned to make was Frosted Flakes, and it was the biz. Hey, don't look at me like that. You did the same thing too. I know you did. Can't tell me that you wouldn't eat cereal for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. Because you can really eat it at any time of the day. It don't really matter. You know what I'm saying? My real ones know what's up. Hey, where are my West Side Frosted Flake eaters at? All right. I feel that. If you're a Frosted Flake eater, let me hear you say, yeah.
Yeah.
Let me hear you say, ooh. I mean, you said, they're great. I mess with y'all. Where are my East Side Captain Crunch eaters at?
East Side!
feel you. I feel you. I just got one small problem. It's there one moment, and it's going to the next. I'm not talking about it just being in your belly. I'm talking because it just dissolved in the milk. That's nasty. It get all soggy and stuff. That's nasty. Like, nobody wants soggy cereal. Like, you just sit there looking at you like... Like, that's nasty. Nobody want to eat that. Hey, no, I'm going to switch it up one time, though. Hey, where are my Southside Apple Jacks? Southside Honey Smacks? Myself, you know, especially Calvin in the back right here. And you know, they just keep saying that I'm all alone. And my mom, too, she be saying, you know, it stink. And it make your breath stink. And you just nasty because you be eating all that nasty cereal.
You stink.
But at the end of the day, we always had cereal in the house. And it was always, I was always eating. Sometimes mom and grandma would cook. And sometimes we had pizza on the weekend. Papa John's and Tummies. Either way, we were rubbing on our tummies. Not because we were starving or hungry, but because we were full and satisfied. We never grew up too spoiled, because whenever we got too carried away, my mom would humble our appetite. Best believe she gave us some tans whenever we were not acting right. Because sometimes we stumble here and there, but most times she just gave us that, don't you dare! And it was always a look with a mean stare. No! Put it down! No! We stop. Hands up. Don't shoot. We don't want no smoke. By the way, when I say we, I'm talking about my younger brother. We're 18 months apart from each other. And growing up, people always say we look like one another. You know, when you see him, you'll know what I mean. People, a lot of times people today disagree. But hey, notice I said younger and not little. When I call him little, it just lowers my self-esteem. Yeah, he's on the tallest side of the family. I'm more in between. Hey, but the doctor said I'm going to be 6 feet when I get older. Just all in my jeans. Hey, but life was always good. It was never routine. Times that were always teaching you new things, and times that were so sweet made you want to relive the whole thing. And that's why today we're going to talk about a lot. We're going to talk about a lot of things, and we're going to talk about a lot of spaces. I want to just make sure that all I ask of you is that you help me make this a safe space. Why today I introduce you to my one-man show, Why Not Be a Hero?
All right.
So growing up for me was like this, right? Waking up early in the morning, hearing music playing from my mama. And I'm not just talking any kind of music. Like I'm talking, before I even say that, I want to ask y'all, how many of y'all had moms just playing music all the time in the house? Yeah. Okay, cool. Well, my mom just wasn't playing any kind of music. It was black women empowerment music. Okay. So, if there was one thing I had to learn, it was that mom was a strong, black, independent woman. You know, and she would just always have her thing going on. And she just wouldn't need help from nobody. I mean, nobody. And so shout out to all the independent moms out there. Y'all do y'all thing. Shout out to Ori, y'all do y'all thing. Y'all hold it down. Hey. Can nobody get that message, period. Hey, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes I just trying to wake up on a simple Saturday morning and get my life together. You know, be playing a game. Back in the day, it was like Frogger, Ape Escape, you know, Ratchet and Clank. Shoot, Nate, that had me feeling like a real trooper. Anybody know about the Ratchet and Clank? Anyway. Those are the days to me. Just mom would just be sitting here with the vacuum cleaner just hauling away, just trying to perform to me like a whole song. It's like, mom, move. And when she would perform to me the whole song, and it would go like this.
Oh, Lord.
Got the vacuum stick cleaner in her hand. Got the vacuum. Just going up. Mom, you're not even vacuuming nothing. Like, that spot being clean, like 3 hours ago. Let's just sing the hook. Come on, sing it. Hey. Man, music was just big in my childhood, you know, like it just made us all feel some type of way. And my mom, you know, it was just really big. And when I remember this movie came out, it was like it got even bigger. So next thing I know, I'm at the movie theater. I'm asking my mom, what is this movie about to see? Like, come on, just tell me. Like, why are you always trying to surprise somebody. Like, I just want to know. We at the theater already? Like, just tell me. She says, okay, here you go. She hands me the car keys. I'm like, what's these for? She says, since you're so anxious, just go ahead and go to the car. We'll see you after the movie's over. What are you talking about? I want to just know what the movie is. She's like, no, you can just wait and watch it like everybody else. All right, fine. So I sit there, give her the keys back, like, because she's trying to test my G. I already know. Mom going, you know, mom don't play games when it comes to that. You don't try to find out the answer to that. Anyways, movie's about to come on. And I sit there, and I remember the first scene came on, and it went like this. Go ahead and name that movie for me. You Got Served! Man, like, it just came out and it just, like, changed history. I mean, like, it had, especially my family, like, everybody out of nowhere just felt like they just wanted to battle. Like, what's up with you, bro? Like, and I remember, you know, we had that one cousin in the family. Everybody got that cousin in the family who's just good at everything. All right, I had a cousin named Dayday. He just always just was dancing, he could sing or rap. It's like, bro, chill out. He's like little mini Chris Brown, like, just sit down somewhere. Hey, but I remember one thing just felt weird. I remember saying, oh, snap, I'm not out there. It was because I didn't know how to dance. See, I still had to learn. And when I tried to get out there, sometimes I was hyped up by my cousins. They'd be like, hey! They'd be laughing at me. And I'm just thinking I'm lit. But then my mom, when I was on that side of the family, mom was like, boy, stop it. What are you doing? Like, you dance like your daddy. my daddy. Like, and you know, my daddy ain't got no rhythm. He got to do one move.
I still got hands, though. I got hands.
But, you know, I realized that I had to fix that because it was really becoming a problem now. Especially when I look up and I'm a sophomore now in high school. That's bad. I have no rhythm at all, and I'm about to have my first school dance. Well, real first school dance. I had two other ones, but I don't count it because nobody was dancing. Well, they was dancing, I wasn't dancing, but I'm going to dance this time, so I don't count it. Hey, so the school dance is on a Friday. It's a Tuesday right now. And I'm like at home. I said, Dion, hey. You at Bourbon Day High School. That's an all-boys school, man. Hey, St. Mary's is about to come over here. They're going to be lit. You need to have it together. You can't embarrass yourself. Come on, D. I'm in the mirror, right? And I turned this song on, and it went like this.
Oh, Lord.
Come on, bro. You got this. My mom just walked in the house. I was by myself, at least I thought. She sitting there looking at me like, what you doing? Mom, I'm trying to dance. I'm learning how to dance. You know, I got a school dance on Friday. And I'm trying. That wasn't dancing. Mom, I know. That's why I'm trying to practice. All right, well, let me show you how it's done. Mom, what are you doing? What are you doing? I'm about to show you how it's done. Mom, stop! Like, what are you doing? What are you doing? Stop! She's like, you want to learn how to dance or not? I said, yes. So she got up. And y'all, she did the worst thing that she could ever do. She puts her hands on my hips. She says, come on, move your hips. She's like, you're too stiff. I'm like, all right. We start practicing, and it went like this. I let go of this little clapping thing that she had me stop doing. She was like, I don't know what that is, stop clapping. She was like, you need something more subtle. So I came up with a snap. I had to snap. The only way I can stay on beat is if I was snapping. So I had this little. All right? And by the time I was over, I had it. I was ready for Friday. Now it's Friday, y'all. It's time for this and show to get the party on the road. And I'm walking in. I enter through those doors. It's this long hallway. I remember that was the best hallway walk of my life. Auditorium up ahead, and there was this girl from St. Mary's. Her name was Rachel. She was like, hi, Dion. I said, hey, Rachel. And I grew walking. I got my ticket. And the song came on, and my heartbeat just started to speed up. I don't know why. It went like this. And I started to feel a jerk. I walking back, so like, okay. And then inside, everybody lit. What's that? By the end of the party, I'm just like the man, and it was just like, I didn't even understand how it came back. It just felt so good. Never felt like that before. And the next thing you know, it was time for the slow songs to come on.
I remember your mother.
And there was this girl, her name was Heaven. She was a senior. I was a sophomore. I looked at her, she's looking at me. We making eye contact. And the song came on. I walked up to her, I said, Heaven, let me talk to you. Hey, y'all. And it was good. It was good. And time just kept going on. And I ended up just being the man of the party. And it just felt good. Like, I never had that much adrenaline going before. I never felt so loved. I never felt so, like, just turned up. Like, I just remember it was like a new story. It was a new growth, a new journey. And, you know, that was really my innocence. I never forget that. I remember when that changed. I turned on the TV screen. And it was the same year. I look up and Trayvon Martin looked just like me. Young black and brown boy, gunned down, was simply just having a hood on, wasn't doing nothing wrong. A journey to the store for Skittles and the Arizona tea. Fought an encounter that turned deadly as he was killed by a neighborhood watching force. And as everything continued, I just remember stepping into this new reality, and it was all around me.
All we want to do is be free. All we want to do is be free. Yeah.
So many physical attributes these other dudes are packing. It's like they're Pac-Man and I'm the ghost that they're attacking. Mm-hmm. See, I get motivated to start stacking to only find myself getting lost and backtracking. And now I'm like, well, why does this happen? I mean, who's to blame? God? Are you the one to blame? Because I should have not asked to be a part of this devilish game. To live in a world where people give up and go insane because the big pictures of what you have a game, but it's yours to claim you were just shortly out of picture frame while God was saying, be patient and wait for the pickup train. But see, no, you get lost in your own thoughts. So you fill up your brain with other names of people who made it to the Hall of Fame. You dribble down these other lanes only to get sent back to from where you came, and now it's a different ballgame. So now you start to feel ashamed. You think that because you're a color that your skin is stained, or that if you're not like Queen Bee, then you'll be slain. But that you're no king if you ain't got big money, big chains, and big signs that claim the hood that you bang. Right. And where does this come from? I mean, it must be the way we were raised, right? So, Mom, are you the one to blame? Because if you and Dad were rich, then I wouldn't have to complain. Life would be easy, and I wouldn't have to change. I would have money so I could take risks and it wouldn't be hard to sustain. But instead, one wrong move and my life is down the drain. And now I'm back at square one. And my next step gets harder because the words of my mom weigh a ton. I get it, Mom, I'm your oldest son. But the words are so lethal, it's like shots just fired from a gun. And I'm black, so one thing I know is when you hear gunshots, you run. And I go anywhere but here because here is no fun. I can't move out either because I don't have no funds. So my next move is money, I'll just go on job hunts. I'll bring home some cash so those bills I can front. Just do my little dance because then I can stunt because I made my mom happy. That's all that I want. Yeah. Right. To make my mom happy. How can I do that? I'm having a hard time making myself happy. So I don't want to blame. Because every time I look up, I feel like I lost. Like I bought something that was a mistake because I didn't know the cost. Now I got a hole in my pockets because they burst from exhaust. Now everything that goes wrong in my life is always my fault. I need to learn to be a man, yeah, I get that a lot. I need to hold everything down and have it on lock. I'm not supposed to cry or show weakness, so I'm just not gonna talk. That's why these wounds just won't stop getting worse, because I keep pouring salt. I should be charged with assault. Because I keep charging at people with the way I talk, head down like that's the way I'm supposed to walk. Depression causes my own thoughts, knowing how contagious it may be, yet I still won't cover my mouth when I cough.
Okay.
I remember my mom and dad separating, all I could do was watch. They hit me real hard, I can't even lie. Like, why did my family household have to be the one to divide? How is it that black love is the one that never seems to survive? Me and my brother, what about us? We were taught that we're supposed to look out for each other, but we barely get along. And all we have was our surroundings, so pride and isolation is what was passed on. I just wish it was as easy as it was on TV, because then I could sing a song. I need to continue to be strong, though, Dion. You're the oldest brother. You got to be strong. Keep moving on. Keep your head up. Just try to learn from your wrongs. And one thing I learned so far is that it's foolish to ask for signs and then ignore them when they're given to you. That true happiness can only come from the Holy Spirit when He's living in you. That sometimes you hurt because you bring it upon yourself.
Right.
And that other times you hurt because you were too busy having expectations for somebody else. And most times, we sit here, we don't even pay attention to the status of our health.
Right.
And other times we know it, but we just too stubborn or prideful to go out and ask for help. But I know for my situation, it will never be the same. The only one to blame is myself. That's why every time I look up from now on, I'll make sure to know, recognize the red flags.
Come on, Dion.
All right.
See, it is different now. 2019 was a heck of a year. I learned a lot. Experienced a lot of hurt, a lot of pain. Everybody got a story, right? It's my story. This one's gonna be a little different. This one's gonna have the people looking at their lives a little rhythm. This one made me think I'm in the kitchen. I'm not the chef, but I can see what I'm not gonna be missing. This one made me think about my life before I die. This one got me being careful with the things I tried. You can do a lot of things, and worse is when you lie. So please be careful with the things you put between your thighs. You will see a lot of things. What matters is the price. Don't bargain with your treasure. Don't be rolling with no dice. Running towards the pleasure is like running with a knife. The hurt that actions cause, it will be stirring up these fights. So let's not fight. Think about it. You can do a lot of things. You always got a choice. If you don't go, it won't need out of things. You can have a lot of plans. You can have a bunch of dreams. You can have a lot of fears, but please don't make them too extreme. Because that can take us down a stream. I remember that it was more lasting than the dream. I remember that I couldn't see how this could be my reality. I never forget the day I ignored my first red flag. I got the option to keep going, but I can't ignore the red flag. I mean, but look how far we came. I feel insane to see these red flags. Man, I know you paid attention the whole time. You seen the red flags. So listen closely. I'm going to tell you a story about the red flags. About some time ago, there was this boy who met this girl. He was the world. He thought she kind of go. Of course, the time will flow. And then they met again and threw head in, and now they kind of flow. Because on the other side, she was holding on to him, and then she said that she don't swim, and now they're trying to get to shore. Now she said she can't be sure, asking why he panicked for. He was trying to be the cure to insecure. It didn't really work, it only got him hurt. Now he gotta change his shirt, no one hears it hurt. The whole family hurt, they didn't like her first. That only made it worse, but he didn't listen to mama when she was talking about drama, so it just got him burnt. Best believe you learned, had to be the hard way. But it's okay, cause now you stay alert. Sometimes you need a jerk, just don't come and make things berserk. Cause you normally take the hit, this time it's gonna make you burst. Red flash. Red flash.
Baby.
I mean, but look how far we came. I feel the same to see these red flags.
Come on, baby.
Yo, man, I know you paying chicks the whole time. You seen the red flags. So listen closely. I'm going to tell you a story about the red flags. How is this possible? So many obstacles. I feel irresponsible. But I'm going to keep fighting still. Because losing is not optional. They tell me that this is ill. But I think we bondable. So I'm going to keep fighting still. Yeah, I'm going to keep fighting still. You tell me you feeling caged. Well, why you not trying still? You tell me you want to dance. Well, you can be wanting still. Because listen, we married now. They told us this fight is real. Fast forward. Now he got a ring on. Trying to get his thing on. Everybody in the building trying to see what he on. It's being cool. He know he got a boo. But he didn't know that boo was acting up and being loose. Because she far away, there was no way he get the news. While y'all here trying to be a man and stripping all their rules. So they can have some food. Somehow he built the strength to take the piercing of this truth. Man, your wife is pregnant and it's not by you. Not by you. Man, your wife is pregnant and it's not by you. It's not by you. Man, your wife is pregnant and it's not by you. It's not by you. Man, your wife is pregnant and it's not by you. It's not by you. Red flag. Story. Because no matter what you go through, it's your story. No matter the obstacles, no matter everything that you've been through, like real talk, what Ori was saying, that's real. Like, own your story. Because reality is, I won't take it back. I can't be mad that it happened. I can hurt, but I won't be upset. I won't regret. I know that everything I've been through, everything, is a learning lesson. And it's an opportunity to grow. And as I look around in this audience right now, at all your faces, you all have your own story. You have the things that you've been through, the things that you go through. The voice sometimes that is crying out on the inside, screaming for help. Because of the things that you've been through and go through. Own your story. Own your story. You know, I say I'm learning to wear my scars. And every time I say that, I think of the movie Black Panther. I think about Killmonger, Michael B. Jordan's character. When he took his shirt off, you counted all his scars. He had like a bunch of them. But he wore them proudly. Even though he was the antagonist of the story, he had a story. And he owned it. And see, when I look at life, the best thing about wearing your scars is that, see, people, the world will sit here and talk about you and tell you that you're weak and that being vulnerable and everything like that, that's you showing a sign of weakness. No, see, wearing your scars is the strongest thing you can do. You know why? Because it shows that you have victory.
That's right.
And the victory is the fact that you're still standing here today.
That's right.
If I had gave up, that would be me losing the battle. Me throwing in the towel. If I didn't show up today. But the fact that I'm here today, I'm still standing.
All right.
That's the victory. And no matter what you go through, you're going to keep on having to keep on walking.
Yeah.
Keep on moving. Keep on stepping with your limb.
All right.
Innocence stolen, and I know I'm.
Doesn't have to mean that you gotta run towards the pops either. Sometimes the problem lies inside of you. And the best thing that you can ever rescue, aside from anyone else, is you of yourself. No. So rescue your joy. Rescue your innocence. Rescue your health. Don't let anyone take that away from you.
Amen.
See, the craziest part about the enemy is that he really has no power. It's a bunch of mind games that we play with ourselves. So when you claim back what's yours, you take back what's yours. You rescue yourself. So remember, it's okay to be you. It's okay to be who you are. It's okay to be yourself. It's okay to reach for help. It's okay to reach for the stars. It's okay to wear your scars. And while sometimes life, everybody wants to sit here and force you to run and push and move at 100. You just feel more like a zero. That's okay. But just remember, at the end of the day, each and every last one of you are a hero. Thank you.
We want to make sure our youth are available to us.
Amen.
But more importantly, adults, we have to make ourselves available to our youth.
Amen.
We heard some songs tonight, maybe brought back some memories. We even heard Back That Thing Up from Juvenile. Tenured folks, it's nothing but Hot Pants 1 and 2 from James Brown.
That's right. That's right.
I'm just letting you know.
That's right.
So we're trying to make sure we don't pass any judgment on our kids.
Amen. Amen.
We have to make sure that we provide an opportunity for dialogue.
Amen.
An opportunity for openness.
Amen.
An opportunity to make sure that we're communicating one-on-one with our children.
Amen.
Very quickly, when Josh was young and we were listening to music and what have you, and I would ask him, what does that mean in a particular song? And if he didn't know or he was trying to act like he didn't know, I would find out for myself. So that when I heard it again with him, I asked him, what did that mean to you? I did the same thing with Jaden to make sure we were always on the same page with what was going inside their ears. I wouldn't just allow things to just go by me and go and let them walk in their room and not understand what they were going through or what they were listening to. I listen to Too Short. I listen to Ice Cube. I listen to Scarface. I listen to Run DMC. I listen to a lot of music. And a lot of things were party time back then. What we're listening to today, and Brother Lamar, Lawrence hooked me up to emo rap, where they're talking about a lot of emotion. And they're talking about a lot of darkness and sadness and anxiety and depression
right.
When our young people are going through right now. And we got to make sure we're listening to what's going on and what's going on into our children's minds right now. Because a lot of things are happening and we got to step forward and be there for our children.
That's right.
That's enough for me. Isaiah 53:5 says, he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement for our peace was upon him. And by his stripes, we are healed.
Hallelujah.
We praise the Lord today.
Hallelujah.
That regardless of what your story is, there is healing in the name of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
There is healing in Jesus Christ. And we can lean on Jesus Christ for that healing. Right now, the doors of the church are open. If there is anybody who does not know Jesus Christ,